Want to know what every web designer's nightmare is? Crafting a masterpiece only to watch it warp and distort across devices. The constant juggle between screen sizes, the endless custom CSS rules, the tedious adjustments with drag and drop builders. It's a game of digital whack-a-mole out there. But what if there was a smarter way? What if the canvas adapted as you painted, ensuring your vision remains pristine no matter the viewport? Welcome to Wix Studio, where responsive design meets intuitive innovation. Let's get into it. If you felt that opening scene hit too close to home, you're in the right place. Hey, it's Brad Hussey back again, and as you probably know, there's a ton of tips and tricks on best practices for optimizing sites for different screen sizes and devices, but forget about all that because Wix Studio is here to do it for you. Seamlessly, every screen, device, orientation, layout, or structure becomes responsive by default thanks to their ingenious features. Pixels become your playground, letting Wix Studio do the screen optimizing work for you. All right, so I got this nice design that I made in Figma right here. Now, this is my new portfolio site. Little sneak peek. I'm gonna force myself to redo my site because I'm gonna make videos about redoing my site in Wix Studio. So that means at the end of it, I get a new site that's actually live. That's gonna be great. Let's start out here and I can choose and add layout elements right here. Rows, columns, cards. I can do a 3-cell collage. I can do a 4-cell collage. I can even do things like select the cell, split it down the middle. I could take another cell, split that down the middle and take that golden ratio it, take it even further, split it, go hard, split it. And I got some crazy Da Vinci sort of like golden ratio going on. I can add content, images. It's all responsive. Like, look at this. If I go down here to tablet view, it's already going to scale down proportionally. I could take this cell section, boom, turn it into like cards and equalize all of it. I don't know what's good. Look at that. It's amazing. I can go up to the tablet view and say, you know what? I want you to be on tablet view. I want you to be rows. I want you to be rows. Look at that. So then you've got like desktop. You've got this cool Da Vinci, you know, Divina Proporzione, you know, magic number sort of like ratio, golden ratio. Tablet, rows, boom. Mobile, whoosh, goes into cards. Like, that's so cool. But I'm not doing that for my portfolio. I got a nice simple grid. So take that, delete button, all breakpoints. Now it's gone. Fresh, clean slate, add a section, Brad. Check it out. Let's add an element here. Let's start off with like a heading. Boom, just gonna throw it up there. It's a little big. Let's make that smaller. 150. Nah, smaller still. 120. All right. Now, I'm gonna add a little bit of an eyebrow text. Quick add. It's gonna be a title, but it's not gonna be a title. It's actually gonna be like a heading 6, but I want its tag to be like a paragraph tag. Perfect. And then I want it to be like gray, site gray. Take this. I'm just gonna line it up roughly. Okay, I'm gonna do this all in a grid in a minute here. Don't worry about it. I'm not dragging and dropping my whole site together. Okay, you drag and drop things into place and then you give it a little bit of order. You kind of put it into place. Sweet. Now, is this in a grid? No. Do any of these elements know that they exist? No. Check this out. Well, it's actually gonna scale proportionally, which is kind of great. Like, kind of just works. Let me just show you how you can create order from chaos here. So check this out. Like, we've got things roughly in their place. Now I can make each of these cells fit these sections. I can make this aligned. I can take this and size it up to be 100% of the width. It's starting to look good. I could take this and I can stack it. I could take that stack, align it to the left, align it to the top. And I could take this button and bring it closer to this. I can stack that as well. I could take that stack, align it to the right, align it to the top, or align it to the bottom because we want to make sure its baseline is with this text here. Perfect. Now, if I wanted to make sure that this was like using proper layout science, I can go here, click the Wix Studio icon, tools, editor, add-ons, get some add-ons, and I'm going to turn on the design guidelines right here. I've already got it installed, so I'm just going to turn that on actually. Boom. Now what I can do is I can take this and I can give this some more space. So what I'm gonna do and make it follow proper conventions. So let's say I want to have some gaps of 30 pixels and 30 pixels. And I want this to go like here. And I want, well, that's really the only thing that's aligning. I can make this stack fill out that cell. And the button can fill out that cell as well if I want. Now, what I really want to do though, is I want to take this whole section and I want to give it some breathing room. It's just too tight everywhere. Let's just do 5% all around. Okay, and then we can just roughly align our cells here. Make sure our text and our stack and everything, it's got space to grow. Now, one more thing here. We want another cell kind of layout here where we got half and half with a little bit of gutter in the middle and empty columns on the left and the right. Easy. So I'm going to add a section and I'm going to say, let's choose two column layout, but let's say I want to select the section and I want to add a column or a cell to the right and one more. Perfect. So now I'm going to turn my columns back on to my design guides and I'm going to just drag this over. To drag this one over as well. And then I'm going to add some gaps. Let's say 30 pixels. Perfect. And we might as well start dragging these around to fit nicely on those. That's right in the center. And that's looking nice there. Perfect. Now you're seeing that I'm dragging these around. What if you want to be like really specific? Like what if you don't really like having to drag that specifically? And you're like, no, I want fine control over my grid. So let's say, for example, I want to split this right here so I can have those two images. So I got this cool collage style layout, but I don't like that I have to drag my, you know, cells around. Well, you could just switch to the advanced CSS grid. So click the section in your inspector panel, go down to the layout, advanced CSS grid, switch. It's going to give you a warning. Do you want to switch to advanced CSS grid? You say, yes, I am a big boy and I'm going to switch. There we go. So now you can be really specific about, I want this to be, you know, 0.5 frames or auto scale pixels, viewport height. You could do anything. You could do calculations. You could do math. You can go all Einstein on it if you really want. Height, width, columns, gutters, gaps. It's all there, just like you're used to with the Editor X experience. If you want to do that, you can. Nice. I want to take this whole section and I want to scale it. Actually, I want to fit it to the screen. Nice. So now we've got our nice layout ready to go. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to add some images. I'm going to select this cell, add the media right from my site file. It's going to be this image of me and I'm going to make sure it's filling that. I want the corners on that to be 80 pixels all the way around. Nice. Let's take some dummy text, edit, paste. Now I don't like that font size, it's too big. Let's make it 32. And then we're going to do max and min. 32 is the maximum font size. It'll scale down to 24 and go no smaller than that as you shrink it down, as you can see. Okay, tablet view. Images are looking a little bit strange there. So maybe what I might want to do is hide a couple of these columns, and mobile needs some attention. So we can do it the manual way where we say tablet view. I want to hide this cell and I want to hide this cell. And then I want the whole section to have some padding on the left and the right, which is going to be 2% and 2%, keeping with the convention that I've already established. Let's check it out. Okay, so desktop, beautiful. Tablet, oh, it's nice. Mobile, not so much. Let's try something here. I'm going to select this layout, this section. And as you can see, we've got this like kind of AI twinkly stars. Get a responsive section on all devices with AI. Once you're done designing the section on the desktop, generate a responsive design with AI so your section looks good on all devices. You can then review, apply, and customize it. So what this is doing, this is in beta mode when I'm playing with it, so I don't know, I might break it. When you watch it, the video, and maybe when you're playing with this, maybe it's in full normal mode and it works perfectly. So what's gonna happen is that this section, not the whole site, but this section, which is great, keeps control. I can generate responsive AI. So it's going to apply layout tools. It's going to optimize for mobile. It's going to try and find the best way of laying this out all with AI. So let's see what happens. So it's only giving me a preview here and I can apply it or discard it. So check this out. Use the handles to preview this. The responsive design was tailored to your section on different devices. So here's my desktop. It looks good. Tablet, what happens? Okay. It's taken out those columns. And then what happens on mobile? It stacks it. Look at that. Now, pretty good. Not perfect. It needs a little bit of space on the sides here and a little bit of space on the bottom. I'm curious what it will do with this section up here. So let's apply that. I think that that's good. So now save me some time. I'm going to go to my mobile view and I want to give this section some space on the top and the bottom. So it stretches out. Kind of cool. I like that. Let's go up to our desktop and let's see what responsive AI does to this section. I'm curious because this is a bit of a, unique section. Maybe I'm giving myself too much credit. It's not that unique of a section, but it's some of my best work. Okay, let's see what responsive AI in Wix Studio did. So this looks like the way we designed it. Shrink down to tablet. It's the same, which is right. That's what I want. Now down to mobile. Ooh, I did not see that coming. I'm actually pretty impressed with this. So let's apply that. Let's head over to our mobile. And like this saved us a ton of time. Check this out. I'm gonna take this text, which is a stack, and I'm gonna make that a little bit smaller space, a bigger button so you can read it. And I kind of like that. I think that that's good spacing right there. A little bit too much spacing between these two. That looks good. Look at that. Oh, it's just so great. With Wix Studio's intuitive approach to site architecture and design, you're not just building websites, you're crafting experiences. That sounds super millennial of me. We're handcrafting organic digital experiences, man. Get out of here. Anyway, remember, you don't need to be a coding wizard or spend endless hours to get it right. Wix Studio empowers you to bring your vision to life and adapt it flawlessly to any device out there. So I encourage you to jump into the platform and start using it today, like right now. And if you're feeling stuck, join us in the Creative Crew. That's my free community of over 2,000 product designers, creative studios, and agency owners who are learning, networking, growing, and leveling up every single week. Don't get left behind in the fast-paced industry that we live in. We'll keep you up to speed. Now, check out this video of me building a one-page website in under 20 minutes using the new Wix Studio and utilizing all the new tools and features that we covered today. I'll see you there.